On the medical watch, spotting a rare reaction to recreational drugs.
Medical reporter Dina Bear has more on a new online training tool.
The digital drill was years in the making, the culmination of a local family's fierce advocacy after a senseless tragedy. Now they're tapping technology to teach medical professionals and students a life-saving lesson they may not find in a textbook.
So the better the history you take, right, probably the better decision making.
Professor Jim Carlson preps his first year physician assistant students for a medical simulation at Rosalind Franklin University in North Chicago.
We like to give them examples of things that are common, things they'll see regularly, but also things that they might not see very often.
In the practice facility, the patient presents with a specific set of symptoms.
Have you taken any medicine?
No, not for this.
Have you taken anything else?
Over the weekend I went out to a concert. I had some ecstasy.
The drill is designed to mimic a real-life scenario.
I felt like a natural fit to go ahead and develop a case study that would help tell Greg's story.
We first covered Greg Friedman's story back in 2019. At the time, his parents, Ross and Nancy, were just beginning to spread awareness about what happened to their son.
We realized that this was a very preventable, unnecessary tragedy.
After he took the illicit drug ecstasy, or MDMA.
This drug altered his brain and his universe.
The synthetic stimulant boosts serotonin and makes you feel good. But as levels plummet in the days following, the drop can cause depression, anxiety, and insomnia, all symptoms Greg felt. And he was struggling with another, more rare effect. Greg was having psychotic thoughts.
He needed appropriate treatment and unfortunately didn't find it.
What the 27-year-old needed was an urgent psychiatric evaluation and to be kept safe.
He found a building nearby and fell off the building backwards to his death. We've been advised that Greg suffered a psychotic break that day. It was precipitated by the ecstasy a week earlier.
The Friedmans have channeled their grief through the GPF Foundation, named for their son, to build awareness and education. They worked with Dr. Carlson and others in the medical community to develop a digital learning tool, one they hope will help clinicians avoid the missteps in Greg's case.
We are truly dialing into the baseline of the medical profession and providing training to this blind spot.
We don't know every diagnosis, no.
Emergency medicine physician Dr. Ron Himmelman says the case study, one of dozens of training scenarios available on the digital platform Full Code, can help students and seasoned professionals.
And I've been around a long time and I learned from it and it tightened up my skills.
The PA students tried it out after their in-person simulation.
At the time, I was like, I have no idea what this is. I thought it was a game.
The objective, not only to spot the signs of psychosis brought on by recreational drug use, but to make the best decisions for the patient.
If we can percentage-wise affect a significant body of the medical world, we know that we will save lives.
As a student, to know that things like this are rooted in someone's personal life, someone's real family tragedy, something that they carry with them all the time. But it's also good to know, and it's nice to have those stories to carry along with you too, because you remember how important what you're doing is.
The platform Full Code, as well as the GPF Foundation, is providing the case study training free of charge, and it's already been accessed more than 20,000 times by medical professionals and students around the world. We have links on our website. Back to you.